I investigated further and called the lawyer to the nominal complainant, Mr. Victor Okoji. And he told me emphatically that I even told the EFCC that Mr. Abaya did not know anything about this matter. This is most unfortunate. At the bar, we are not protecting the bad egg, and we are not saying that we are perfect, though we are learned. Any lawyer that is found wanting, this branch or the Nigerian Bar Association will not protect. But we will not allow any organization, no matter how highly influenced or no matter how powerful, to intimidate us or punish the innocent. See, the act of the Ilorin Office of the Economic and Financial Commission is highly condemnable, and this has been on for long. At our last law week, I still made mention to it that lawyers, we are humans. If there's any allegation against them, inform us as a branch so that we can produce the person. And I condemn the act of displaying a suspect carrying placard. Because once you have displayed someone online carrying placard, you have already condemned him in the public opinion, in the public courts. Yes, the public opinion will be against him. This negates the principle of the Constitution, particularly Chapter 4, Section 36 of the 1989 Constitution. We presume every Nigerian innocent of an allegation against him. Now that you have condemned them, what of if the court said they are not guilty? How will you address this issue? So this is most unfortunate. So the Economic and Financial Crime Commission and other prosecuting and investigating agencies must, as a matter of urgency, come to caution. It is wrong to post the picture or any data of a suspect undergoing investigation on internet or any other media outlet. They should have to wait until there is a prima facie case against him. Now, their picture have been posted everywhere, tagging them as criminals. This is most unfortunate. And of course, I want to inform the member of the public that the branch will support Mr. Abaya 100% in seeking the course of justice. If this is happening to lawyers, then what will happen to ordinary Nigerians on the street? And I will say it as my last comment on this, that I will reiterate it again, that the branch will give Mr. Abaya full support in redressing the wrong that has been done to him. Thank you, gentlemen.
However, just on Friday, 30th of August 2018, EFCC officers and operatives involved in this dehumanization have started to apologize to me for disparaging my personality. But I insisted, and I still insist, that they must apologize to me publicly. I am convinced that since my release, the picture of my innocence has become clearer to the EFCC itself. Father, I speak to you right now. They have conscience, it will be telling on them. But the damage done to me and my reputation by the action of the overzealous officers of the EFCC are incalculable, immeasurable, and ought to be adequately redressed. I clearly stated my story in connection with the case as narrated above. But despite my explanations, and notwithstanding that I was not confronted with any document I allegedly forged or any allegation that I collected any amount of money from anybody or received any amount of money on behalf of anybody in connection with the case, the officers of EFCC threatened and forced me against my will to carry placards and my photograph, which they later uploaded in the internet. In fact, as I speak to you, I am reliably informed that the photograph has been removed from their system. The whole world has undoubtedly seen me carry placards. Please retake a deep look at that picture, and you will see that it was hesitantly carried with one hand. For more than 1 hour, I resisted and protested the carry of placards. But EFCC called on two of our mobile policemen who pointed gun at me and coerced me to carry it. In fact, at the heat of that moment, I was told that governors and senators do carry it. As soon as the picture was taken, EFCC released me together with my car.
I knew it was false because the lawyers involved in this case, particularly Barrister Sulyman Abaya, is a person I have a long-standing relationship with. I know him to be a man of honor, a man of personal integrity and good character. In fact, he's a role model to all young lawyers in Ilorin. Like he has said earlier on, his integrity and personal reputation earned him the secretary who he was voted for overwhelmingly by the members of the branch, Ilorin. The act of EFCC in this regard is totally condemnable. It is condemnable because you don't be a judge in your own case. You have a case before you, you do your thorough investigation. A situation whereby you bring a case before the media, prosecute your case before the media, and pass your judgment is totally wrong and unconstitutional. It's of this reason why we are totally supporting Barrister Sulyman Abaya.